Hello, I am Boggs, and this is a short tutorial on how you can use Made Transitions on Premiere Pro. As you can see, I already have created a timeline and a simple edit, a cut, rough cut over here, and let's place a transition to see how it works. I have also loaded some transitions inside. Let's use the liquid ones, and as you can see, I have a lot of them here. In Premiere, you can always double-click on the transition and preview it over here on the source, or change the icon view, go to liquid, and you can preview them like so. But I have an easier solution, and this solution is that you can find in all my products that I'm selling on VideoHive. Beside all the effects that you will buy from me, you will always find a preview all HTML file. And if you double click on it, you will see all the transitions at once, and you can select which one you prefer, let's say 20. And by the way, it's a local file, so you don't need an internet connection. Let's go back to Premiere. Let's take 20 and place it above footage B. Zoom a bit. Align the transition with the footage, as you can see over here. And then go to effects, write track, and we need the track mate key. Double click or just drag and drop on the footage. And here on the effect, says mate and has a drop down to select which mate we want, and our mate in this case is on video 3, channel 3. Select it and the transition plays just fine. By the way, let's disable it for a moment. You will see this transition has an alpha channel because you can see the footage underneath. Some of the transitions doesn't have alpha channel and they are luma, like the fires I have over here. You see? You cannot, the footage underneath is hidden. The procedure remains the same, except when you have Luma, except the fact that here on the Mate Alpha, you have to choose Mate Luma. And of course, enable the effect. And the transition again plays just fine. Remember that Alpha transitions play with Luma, but Luma transitions doesn't play with Alpha. Okay. And now, when we play this, transition is okay, but when it ends, again we see the footage underneath. In order to fix that, we have to take the Razor tool and cut it, or Ctrl K on your keyboard, and cut it where the transition ends. And now, over here in the footage, we just disable the effect. And everything plays fine for the rest of the footage. Okay, let's place an out transition. Let's take again, 25, okay, 25 out, place it again in the end, align it, go to the beginning, cut the footage, Ctrl K, and over here I have already the effect on, so I will just enable the effect, and the transition plays again as it should. That's how you can use Made Transitions in Premiere Pro, and one tip is that right now you have 5 clips. A lot of cuts and 2 channels occupied. It's best when you do everything, just select them all, right click and nest. Write whatever you want, ABC, AESD, whatever. And now you have just one single footage that plays awesomely and just fine. Of course, this is alpha, the black area over here, as you can see. And if you double click on the nest, you can edit again the footage as you please or the transitions. You can replace them, by the way, a second tip. Let's say it's very easy to replace a transition in Premiere. Okay, let's take, I don't know, for 15. Place it over here. Delete the remaining. Realign the cut. And now you have a new transition. Delete it. Take, I don't know, 26 in, whatever. Again, realign the cut. And everything plays just fine, and if you go back to your timeline, you see the transition is changed. That's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this was helpful. In case you didn't understand my accent, sorry for that. That's the best I can do. And if you want to check my transitions, you will find some links in the description below. Have an awesome day. Bye. Cheers.